morning, everyone. God bless you, and welcome to the Hour of Power from Faith City Family Church, our 9 a.m. celebration service. And we're so happy to have you with us today, especially on Faith and Friends Day. Let's give the Lord a hand clap of praise together, a loud praise. Faith and Friends Sunday, whether in person, whether online, we're always making new friends, not only in person, but online as well. And I'm thinking of that scripture out of Proverbs chapter 18, where Jesus said, "He is a friend that sticketh closer than a brother. A man that hath friends must show himself friendly, and there is a friend that sticketh closer than a brother." How many are glad you can say Jesus is your friend today? He is your friend. He's my friend. Oh, I thank God for that. And speaking of friends, you know, friends, they also help one another. They pray for one another. They encourage one another. And we want to encourage you, if you would, to get in your prayer request that we might pray for you today. After the praise and the worship on Facebook, do send message or comment, YouTube, the chat section. And our prayer ministry team will get those requests, and we're going to call out to God and pray for you and believe for the miracles that you need. I want everybody to say this after me. Shout it with me. Say, "In the name of Jesus, this is my hour of blessing. This is my hour of miracles. This is my hour of increase and acceleration. In the name of Jesus, amen and amen." Would you give the Lord another shout? We believe it together. Welcome everybody to the Hour of Power.
Praise the Lord this morning. Are you alive in Jesus today? I know I am. If you are, can you put your hands together? Come on.
I was lost with a broken heart. You picked me up and I was set apart. From the ash I am born again. Forever saved. Savior's hands. You are more than my words could say. I'll follow you over all my days. I'll fix my eyes following your ways. Forever free and unending grace.
It says because you are our freedom.
Oh!
wherever you are, you may be watching us. We're gonna give God all the glory and praise. Is that all right with y'all? Hey. Yeah. Lord, I give you praise. With a shout, my voice I raise. Lord, I give you praise. Hallelujah, I give you praise. Hallelujah, I give you praise. Yeah, 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 yeah. We bless your name, Lord. You pray.
Lord, I give you praise.
With the shout,
with the shout,
yeah.
My voice I raise.
Lord, I give you praise.
Lord, I give you praise.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hey.
I give you praise.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. I give you
hey.
Praise.
Hey, we're gonna take it up a little higher, yeah. We love you, Lord. We worship you, God. Yes, we do. Lord, I give you praise.
Lord, I give you praise.
With a shout.
With a shout.
Yeah.
My voice I raise.
Lord, I give you praise.
Lord, I give you praise.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. I give you praise.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. I give
hey.
You praise.
So you are worthy
upon my praise.
And I will sing of your great name.
You know, that is a happy sound. How many know the joy of the Lord is your strength today? No matter what you're going through, no matter what you're facing, the joy of the Lord is your strength. I want you to raise up your hand and shout, I got joy. Come on, shout, I got joy. I got joy, I got joy. On Faith and Friends Sunday, I've got the joy. See, the joy from Jesus is not predicated on how good things are going in your life. Matter of fact, your joy level sometimes goes a little higher when you're going through the valley of the shadow of death. Because David said, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil. I got the joy, amen. You are with me. Somebody shout, I got the joy a couple more times. I want you to turn around to somebody and point at them and say, I got the joy. Say, I got it, I got it. I got the joy, I got the joy. He is all I need, he is all I need. I got the joy, praise God. We're going to get ready to pray in a couple of minutes here. But, you know, I got to thinking about Friend Sunday. And Brother Dana, that old hymn of the church, what a friend we have in Jesus. You like that one? All our sins and griefs to bear. And what a privilege to carry. Oh, everything to God in prayer. And oh, what peace we often forfeit. And oh, what needless pains we bear. It's because we do not carry everything to God in prayer. How about that chorus again? What a friend. Oh, what a friend we have in Jesus. Our sins and griefs to bear, and what a privilege to carry everything to God in prayer. Oh, what peace we often forfeit. Think about that. Praise the Lord. I mean, somebody's about to turn some things over to Jesus. Oh, what needless pain we bear, all because we do not carry everything to God in prayer. You know, on Faith and Friends Sunday, Brother Harmon, ushers, if it be all right, I want to invite people, I feel it in my spirit, to begin to come down the aisles for prayer today. You need prayer for a family member. You're going through a struggle. You need the friend Jesus to help you out. Come on down to the altar right now. Come on down. Come on down. Something inside said, open up the altar of the church. Let people come to the cross today. Let them bring their burdens to Jesus. That's it. Come on. Come up close to the cross. There's power when you take that step of faith. There's power when you say, you know what? I've done everything I know to try. But what I'm going to do is I'm going to bring it to the cross today. I'm going to take it up to Jesus. Oh, yes. And we're going to let him have it. Somebody say, I'm going to let him have it. Huh? See, we don't let the Lord have it sometimes. It can really mess us up and it can kind of, you know, bring us down. But I'm glad to tell you, when the Bible said, cast your care upon Jesus, you can know for a fact that he cares for you and he's going to get you through it. He's going to take you by the hand and he's going to help you get it all worked out. Can I hear an amen? God is an able God. God is absolutely able to do it. Give the Lord a praise right now. Thank you, Jesus. My God, on Faith and Friends Sunday, I feel many of you watching right now as tears are coming down your face. We're going to turn it over to Jesus. Can we stretch our hands out to each other? The Bible said, pray ye for one another. What it said in James, pray for one another that you might be healed. Now, Father, in the name of Jesus, I stretch my hands out to you. To all my friends, because friend Jesus, you told us to agree in prayer. Lord, I'm praying for all my friends today here at the church, the many that are watching us online. Lord, they've got some big burdens they've been carrying around, and I pray, Lord, you'd give them the strength and the faith to turn that over to you right now. That loved one that doesn't want to seem to communicate, that friend that doesn't want to connect, that situation that seems to get worse the more that we pray. Well, devil, we want to let you know something, Satan. We don't go by what we see, and we don't go by what we hear. We go by faith. The Bible said the just will live by their faith. And many times when it looks its worst, that's when God is doing his greatest work. Father, I gotta say that again. When it looks worse, that's when God many times is doing his greatest work. Father, in the name of Jesus, we ask you today to do your great work on Faith and Friends Sunday. In the name of Jesus. If you got somebody on your heart right now, just raise your hand up to heaven and just say it. They're gonna be all right. Come on, say it. They're gonna be all right. They're going to be all right. She's going to be all right. He's going to be all right. Oh, hallelujah, God. That's our level of faith today. We believe she'll be all right, Lord. He'll be all right. It'll turn around, Jesus. It won't always be this way. God, we thank you for it in the mighty name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Praise God. Praise God. Brother Richard, it won't always be this way. God's going to turn it around. Keep the faith, my good brother, in the name of Jesus. What a friend you have in Jesus. What a friend we have in Jesus. Lord, as we lift up all these requests to you in prayer right now. And now I want everybody, if you would, let's take a moment and give people a chance to receive Jesus. What a better day on a Faith and Friends Sunday at a church to say, I need a friend that will stick with me when it gets tough. You know, some people, they mean well, but when times get tough, they'll leave you real quick. I mean, when you got plenty of money, you got plenty of this, you got plenty, they'll want to hang around with you. We all know what that's like. But just go through a valley, go through a struggle for 6, 9 months or a year, all of a sudden they want to change their mind. I better get out of here. It looks like it's getting bad, but how many are glad you can say Jesus will not leave you and he will not forsake you today. He won't walk out. He'll hang in there with you. Yes, he will. Would you like Jesus to be your Savior? He'd like to be your Savior. He just wants you to give him permission, that's all. If you'll call on Jesus, he'll save you right now. You don't have to worry about anything. Just give it to Jesus. So I want us all to pray a prayer together of salvation. I want us to say it loud. Because somebody here at this service today, somebody told you that good people go to heaven. Well, good people really don't go to heaven. Only saved people go to heaven. And listen, be a good person. You should be a good person and help people. But only Jesus can get you to heaven today. If you'll call on him, he'll save your soul. and you won't have to worry about it. Are you ready to say this prayer with me here? The many of you watching right now, come on, repeat it with us with our praise team here. Everybody say, I believe, Jesus, that you did die on the cross for every sin I would ever commit. Right now, Lord, I need a friend. I need a friend like you. And on friend day at the church, I ask you, Jesus, be my friend. Be my Savior. Be my Lord. I confess my sin. Come into my life, Jesus, and wash my sin away. I receive you right now, Jesus, as my Lord and my Savior. Thank you, Jesus. I am saved. Can you raise your hand and thank the Lord, your friend? He's a friend. Yes, what a friend you have. What a friend I have in our Jesus. He will not leave us, and he will not forsake us. If you all stay right where you are, I'm going to ask Brother Harmon to get somebody to get in his place and bring up somebody, bring the request to me from online. And we're going to just stretch our hands out, beloved, at the altar, if you'll stay there. And we're going to stretch our hands out from everywhere. Those of you online, we're going to ask you to stretch your hands out as well. And then we're going to call on Jesus. Then the final thing I want to do, after I do that, I want to pray for miracles. How many of you need a miracle in your life? Would you shout amen? You need a door to open. You need to feel healing in your body. You need just a turnaround. I know in my own life, when it looked like it was hopeless, the Lord finally came on through. How many know he's a finally come on through Jesus? Yes, he is. He will finally come on through. Brother Harmon, thank you today. I want us all to stretch our hands out to these requests. And I want us all to shout these words together. Every one of us, I want us to shout. Everybody say, in the name of Jesus, we lift up every request. We rebuke sickness in the name of Jesus. We rebuke pain. We rebuke depression. We bind you, devil, in the name of Jesus, off of every one of these situations right now. I want you to say this. Say, God, honor the faith of the people today that have got their request in. Lord, we praise you for it. The healing is now. The deliverance is now. The turnaround is right now. In the mighty name of Jesus. Hallelujah for every one of them. In Jesus' name, somebody give a shout right now. Hallelujah. God, we thank you. God, we praise you. Hallelujah. Miracles do happen. It says Jerry is asking God to keep him strong because he's celebrating his 29th year of being sober, and he wants to stay that way. How about a praise God for that? You know that's a miracle, is it not? And if God did that for 29 years, he said, Lord, just help me to stay on track. Father, help him stay on track in the name of Jesus. Help him to stay free, Jesus. In your precious name we pray. And now, everybody, I want us to pray for the many in church and online. Somebody needs a right now miracle. Somebody shout right now. Shout it louder right now. One more time right now. Father, in the name of Jesus, right now we are praying for healing in this sanctuary. We are praying deliverance from depression in this sanctuary. We are praying for provision to come on my people in this church right now. Father, we are praying that the works of the devil be defeated in the name of Jesus in every life, in every family. We look at you right now that are watching, and in the name of Jesus, we all agree together in the church, in person, and the many online right now. We bind the devil and we ask the Lord to heal you right now, to deliver you right now, to provide for you right now, to turn it around right now. In Jesus' name we pray. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Praise him, somebody. You know the Lord answers prayer. You don't have to give up. All you have to do is look up, and it's going to be all right. Glory to God. Glory. Give the Lord a loud praise, would you, my dear brothers and sisters? Glory to God. Amen, amen, amen. Before you're seated, I want you to go up to two or three people and say, you're my friend. Come on, tell them, say, you're my friend. Amen. You're my friend. Yes, in Jesus, you're my friend. Somebody said, well, I never talked to you a day in my life. Well, you're still my friend. You're my friend in Jesus. Hallelujah. Brother Dana, you're my friend. Amen, brother. Praise God. All my brothers on the platform and my sisters, they are my friends. Yes, Jesus. Faith and Friends Sunday. Faith City Family Church. In person, online. We are friends. Hallelujah. Somebody shout, praise the Lord. And somebody shout, God is good. And somebody say, I'm on my way to Canaan's land. That's an old gospel song they used to sing. Canaan land means the promised land. And so I'm on my way to the best life I've ever had. Is there an amen from somebody on that? Don't you let the devil get you down. Because I'm here to tell you, you're on your way to Canaan land. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Is there one more? Praise the Lord. I felt it when I said it. I'm on my way. They sang, praise the Lord. I'm on my way to Canaan's land. Amen. Then they used to sing, if you won't go, don't hinder me, because I'm on my way to the Canaan's land. Amen. Well, you know, the mission of the church here at Faith City is to help others get on their journey to the Canaan land that God has for them. So many people outside the walls of the church today that need to know that Jesus, He is the way, the truth, and the life. Jesus is the answer. The summer of salvation continues as the ministries are out all summer long in neighborhoods, in communities, reaching out. And right now, we are planning and working on the next Festival of Hope, where we're going to go into an area that needs a whole lot of hope in Jesus. But not only are we going to give the Lord a praise with the message of Jesus and the gospel, but we're going in with the community partners and organizations that are able to hire people and give them jobs. Organizations that we partner with that provide counseling, grief counseling, tutoring, and mentoring, all this for free, a guidance on how to get education and scholarships and how to take your life from where it is now. Because, listen, it doesn't matter how low you are, God can get you up out of the pit if you'll just take your first step. Give me an amen on that. And the Festival of Hope says we're here to help you make the first step to get up out of the pit. One of the newest things we've started with the Festival of Hope is the Record Expungement Program, where we're helping people get their records expunged for light offenses that have been on there for 10 years and 11 years and 13 years, and they still can't get the job they deserve, still can't participate in society. You know what? It's time to let the people free be free. Let them go in the name of Jesus. And at our last Festival of Hope, matter of fact, I don't know, BK might have some footage, but I'm going to show you a little bit what of a Festival of Hope is like. And I believe the next one is going to be our greatest one. That was one of the Festival of Hopes where they were out there lined up way an hour and a half in advance to get into the community center because they heard about the Festival of Hope. And finally, when we got on the inside, my and all of the community partners were there. Folks kept filling up the place. It took them about 40 minutes to get in there. And as they were coming, I would do little mini gospel messages. I would preach like a 7 to 8 minute message and then get people saved, and then another group would come on in. Our community partners, you see them there, there to help the people know what resources are available to them. That was our free book table for families, for Christian books for children to read. We were giving them away. There was a big sock distribution given away. There were clothes given away. And you still see them coming in the door there. There was the health expo table that was there. People were able to be there for hours during today and not only get Jesus and turn over their prayer requests, but they were also able to get real help so their children can do better, so their children can get help with their homework. Many of these folks, they don't have the money for the help. Their sister Miracle, now she, I think, is in North Carolina right now, but she was out there singing because in that same neighborhood, I believe she had got arrested for drugs, but Jesus saved her, and now she's a minister for Christ in song. Can somebody give a praise the Lord right now? Come on, give a loud praise. That's the work of the church, see? Go in and bring transformation to communities and to neighborhoods. After the services today, Brother Harmon and myself will be meeting together, and we're going to be, I believe, scouting some areas that need some real help. You pray for us. We're planning going to drive into those areas today. They're rough areas. They're dangerous areas. But how many know we don't run from the trouble? You got to run to the trouble. Come on, say amen. You don't run from the battle. You run to the battle. I wish I could get a shout out of somebody today, because Jesus is the answer. Today, as we come to the offering time, where we ask you to be faithful in your tithes and in your offerings. The Bible says in Malachi chapter 3, we know this verse so well, the tithing verse. It says, and bring all the tithe into the storehouse, that there may be meat in my house. And prove me now, herewith says the Lord of hosts, if I will not open you a blessing from the windows of heaven. Yes, and I'll pour out that blessing from those windows, and there will not be room enough to receive it. I will rebuke the devourer for your sake. The Bible says when we look at our paycheck and say, God, I thank you that I had some money, but I didn't make this money by myself. You woke me up in the morning. You gave me health and strength to make this money. The Lord said, when you give 10% of that paycheck, he said, I'm going to do three things. He said, I'm going to pour out a blessing. He said, I'm going to give you increase in your life, and I'm going to give you protection. Amen to that. Today, as we come before you, are asking for three things today. Number one, that you would be faithful in your tithing and in your offerings today. We have two special needs on our Faith and Friends Sunday. We need some difference makers today. As Brother Harmon and I scout the land on the next location for this next big Festival of Hope outreach during our Summer of Salvation initiative. Today we need 30 people who will be a difference maker to help with our Summer of Salvation community outreach. A difference maker gives a special offering of $100. And so we're asking today, could we get that? Brother Harmon, I believe if we get the resources, we've never been afraid to go anywhere. You got saved in this church, Brother Harmon, so you've been with me a long time. We'll go to the gates of hell. You know why? Because Jesus said the gates of hell will not prevail against the church. How many believe the drug dealer can become the evangelist? Come on, say amen. The young lady who got arrested, busted for drugs, now she's in the same neighborhood singing Christian rap music. Jesus said the gates of hell will not prevail against the message of the gospel. Can I get a few folks to prime the pump today that will say, Pastor, let me raise up my hand. And I want to be, listen, we need at least 30 today to help us, because we don't want to let the community down. We don't want to let the people down. Who would raise up their hand and say, by faith, I'm going to sow that $100 difference maker offering. Pastor, let me raise up my hand. Could I get just a few right now, just four or five to prime the pump to get it started? Would you raise your hand up right now? The ushers will help me count. I will be the first one. Who would be the second one? I know that God's going to pour it out on you. He's going to bless it. There's one right now. Could I get a third one in the name of Jesus to encourage people to get behind this. There's a third one. Could I get at least five? Who'll be number four right now? I know the devil is. There's number four. Thank you, Jesus. Who'll be number five? Praise God. There's five, the ushers say. Amen. And we believe there's another one. There's six. Listen, God's going to bless your children. You reach somebody else's child, God's going to reach your child sooner or later. It's going to happen. So believe with me today that God will raise up those 30 individuals that will sow that difference maker offering of $100. Before I pray, I'm going to ask the ushers to come in the church. If they would come to the front, begin to give out the envelopes. If you did not receive a tithe and offering envelope, please raise your hand today. We want to have a record of that. Ushers, make sure everyone has one, if you would. Those of you that are online, so good to have you. As we bring God's house to your house today, you can give in the following ways. These are safe. These are secure. You can text to give at the 302-455-2820. Again, 302-455-2820. Tithes, offerings, difference maker offerings. You can also use the Cash App. While those of you in church are preparing your tithes and your special difference maker offerings, I'm continuing to review these giving options. $ Faith City FC2, the Cash App, tithes and offerings. You can download the giving app, Faith City Family Church, the church app on your Apple or Android device. You can also go to faithcitynow.com and click donate. And also, you can by mail send in your tithes and offerings to 179 Stanton Christiana Road, Newark, Delaware, 19702. I'm glad I took a step back here and I looked at my notes on this 3x5 card. Another reason we need your help today, because we're so much into outreach and soul winning. That's about all we talk about around here. But I was talking yesterday to Brother Gino, one of the men of the church, and the church steeple is in need of serious work. He said, Pastor, going to have to get a crew of men. We're going to have to re-anchor some things up there. The weather, the high winds have taken its toll, and we're going to have to do some work. As I stand here, I don't know how much money that's going to cost. But how many know God will make a way? Can I hear an amen? I'm not in construction. I don't know anything about it. But I know that God knows about it today. So I'm glad I saw that on my card. Would you remember that in your tithes and in your offerings as well? Because that will have to be addressed immediately. Father, in the name of Jesus, what a joy and what a privilege it is. What a fellowship, what a joy divine to lean on the everlasting arm. Father, I'm praying today that people will say, Pastor, I know if I take care of God's house, He's going to take care of my house. I know as I give money to reach other families, God will take care of my family. He'll get them all saved somehow, some way. Father, I pray that you'll give us the help that we need, not only for the summer of salvation, but Lord, to be able to do the much-needed work that I discovered yesterday. I got the lowdown on it. Lord, I don't understand the details, but Lord, I know we have to get a crew out here. And so, Father, I pray that people will say, I'm going to help in the name of Jesus, because I know I cannot go wrong by blessing the house of God. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen and amen. How about a praise the Lord from somebody? Isn't it a privilege? Isn't it a joy to be able to give? I will be back in just a few moments as we prepare our tithes and our offerings. We love you. God bless you. Just before we dedicate all the tithes and the offerings, I'd like the ushers to prepare to come at this time. And Father, in the name of Jesus, we dedicate every tithe, every special outreach offering. Father, in the name of Jesus, we pray that you would bless it back to your people. Good measure, pressed down, shaken together, and running over. In the name of Jesus, we pray. God, we know that we cannot outgive you. Luke 6 and 38 says it's coming back in the ways that we need it most. In Jesus' name, we celebrate cheerful giving. Amen and amen. Thank you, ushers, for waiting on everyone and those of you that are worshiping with us online as we bring God's house to your house. Thank you from the bottom of our hearts today. When the ushers are through, I'm going to get them to help me out, if they would please, with a couple more things after they've served everyone. But I want to remind that everyone today on Faith and Friends Sunday, we want to thank anybody who is visiting the church today, anybody online that is visiting as well, because times are unique. People are worshiping online just like they are in person. So I want us all to put our hands together for visiting friends today. Would you help me give them a loud praise the Lord? Amen. In person or online, for all friends on Faith and Friends Sunday. Now, I want to make sure you know about a couple of things, at least two or three things, as our ushers are preparing to help me. First, I'm going to be telling you about a gentleman by the name of Dietrich Haddon. And then after that, I'm going to be talking about baptism ushers in that order. But I want to remind everyone about Wednesday. Wednesday is our Bible study from 7 to 8 p.m. It is virtual only. But I'm very excited about a gospel artist that's coming in. He's all the way from Los Angeles. Dietrich Haddon, one of the top Billboard gospel artists in the world today. He's coming in concert. Give the praise the Lord for that. Ushers, would you come to the front row, please? And I want everybody to take at least two, if not more, of these invite cards. The Dietrich Haddon Live in Concert is free admission. It's absolutely free. We're doing this as an outreach. Pastor Dietrich Haddon, not only is he a musical genius, but he's also an anointed man of God. And I want you to make sure you bring your family and friends. The doors open at 5. It begins at 6. And trust me, Dana, you know this guy. This guy is one of the best that's out there. I mean, he's going to bless us. He's going to rock this place with praise. And it's free. Doors open at 5. It begins at 6 p.m. with Dietrich Haddon. Also, as our ushers preparing to help me with our baptism, next Sunday is Baptism Sunday. That is the 24th. Go ahead and give God a praise for that. People are wanting to get baptized. Ushers, if you come to the front once again, please, at this time, we want to put in your hand a baptismal reminder card and an invite card, all right? So if we could do that, ushers in the center, if you have them, bring them up front as well. We appreciate that. So that's coming up next Sunday. And so we have today Friends Day. We have Baptism Sunday. We have August the 6th. Dietrich Haddon in concert. Now everybody say today. Everybody say today. Now today, after the 11 a.m. service, we are going to be having our Faith and Friends free barbecue. After 11 a.m., rain or shine, absolutely free, delicious barbecue. Some of you, the only time that you can attend church is right now. We understand that. But if your schedule works out and you want to come by after the second service, you are welcome to do that on Faith and Friends Day. Why are we doing this? To encourage fellowship, togetherness, and faithfulness, and to remember the importance of the house of the Lord. So I hope you'll be a part of these things coming up. We're going to have a great time together. Let's put our hands together and give God a loud praise right now. Lord, we're thankful we are pressing through these times. This message God gave me I believe is strategic and it's right on time. I'm going to let the Holy Ghost lead me because I believe it's a word from God today. It's a very short title for a message, but sometimes condensed is powerful. It's a title, two words, Go Forward. Go forward. What are you going to do when you get knocked down? You're going to get up and do what? Go forward. What are you going to do when what you planned didn't work out, didn't go anywhere like you thought it would? You're going to get back up. You're going to go forward. What are you going to do when you feel like absolutely you have been betrayed, you can't trust anyone, you're emotionally depleted? What are you going to do, child of God? You're going to get back up. You're going to go forward. The doctor gives you the diagnosis you didn't want. You thought you were getting better, but according to his stats and his records, it's not going in your direction. You're going to keep the faith, and you're going to go forward. We're going to make our opening text a little bit of a story. We're going to pull out some verses out of a true story that happened in the Bible where God was telling his people, I know it's tough. I know these are hard times. I know that your life is at risk, literally, out of this certain story in the scripture. But he said, I want you to go forward. Because, friend, if you'll just go forward and you'll keep your faith, there's nothing that the Lord cannot navigate you through. Give the Lord a praise. In Exodus chapter 14, we're going to read a little synopsis of this story here. And the Lord said unto Moses, wherefore criest thou unto me? Moses was kind of melancholy. He was crying. He was feeling bad and despondent. The Lord said, why are you crying unto me? Speak unto the children of Israel and tell them to do this. Go forward. The next verse goes on to read, but not only tell them to go forward, but now I want you to do something. Lift up the rod that is in your hand. Stretch out thy hand over the sea. In other words, God said, whatever you have in your hand, use it. Hold it up in the air and divide the sea. And the children of Israel shall go. He didn't say, now it's going to happen, I guarantee it. It was all a step of faith. He could have held that staff up and nothing happened. But God said, go forward, hold up that piece of wood, and the children of Israel will go on dry ground through the midst of the sea. Next verse said, and I behold, God said, if you'll do what I tell you, quit crying, quit complaining, go forward, hold up this stick of wood. Behold, I will harden the hearts of the Egyptians, and they shall follow them, and I will get me honor or revenge upon Pharaoh and upon all his hosts, the people that follow him, upon his chariots and upon his horsemen. Verse 18 says, and the Egyptians shall know that I am the Lord thy God, when I have gotten me honor upon Pharaoh, upon his chariots, and upon his horsemen. We all know the miracle I'm talking about. It was the parting of the Red Sea. But the miracle began with two words. And the two words were when God said to Moses, stop crying and go forward. Everybody shout, go forward. A little bit louder, go forward. Now I have a question here. Why were the Israelites to go forward? As you read this story in the Bible, why were they to go forward? Well, God said this. Here's the answer. God said they had a choice. He said, you can go forward or you can stand still. Now, if they would have stood still, the enemies of Pharaoh would have come upon them. And they would have been destroyed. Them, their children, their grandchildren, everything would have been gone. But what they had to do is to make a choice. Now, it's pretty hard to say, I'm going to make the choice to go forward, and the first step you make is going to be in the water. How many know that's a difficult choice? But how many believe the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, when he tells you to go forward, he will either part the water or let you walk on top of the water or make the water disappear? Because when God tells tells you to go forward, he has a purpose in you going forward. He doesn't want a pity party. He doesn't want you feeling sorry for yourself. He wants you to go forward. Leave in the doctor's office with tears in your eyes, read the verses on healing, and go forward. Your children say, I won't serve God. Read what the word said, my house shall be saved, and go forward. You can't get a job. Doors have closed everywhere you go. Have faith, believe God, sow a seed, and move forward, because nothing can stop the power of God or the people of God. God has a perfect track record. The devil loses, and God always wins. Oh, here's another truth here. Number two, you see, the marching orders from Christ to the Christian are to go forward all throughout the Bible. As soon as you get saved, here's what the Bible says to you and me, the Christians. In Mark chapter 16, verse 15, and he said unto them, go ye into all the world and preach the gospel to every creature. The word there is go. Matthew 28, verse 19. Go, there's another verse. Go ye therefore and teach all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father, the Son, and of the Holy Ghost. Go, he said. Go. Verse number 20, he says, after verse 19, he said, teach them to observe all things that I've commanded you. And lo, when you go, I am with you always, even until the end of the world. I've got a question here. Why is the Christian to go forward? Why is the Christian to go forward in spite of life circumstances? I know I'm talking to about everybody here and the many of you watching online. There is something, at least one, two, maybe three things that's trying to hold you back. We're living in unprecedented times. We're trying to exit unprecedented times. But guess what? The church doesn't stop being the church in a pandemic. Jesus does not stop being Jesus in a pandemic. I need some louder amens than that today. Jesus is the same yesterday, today, and forever. Why is the Christian to go forward in spite of life's circumstances? Well, first of all, the scripture says, first of all, that living in neutral not only hurts us, but it hurts those who are around us. It's not just negative for our own personal and spiritual and physical progress, but it is actually a hindrance to those that are in our space and in our world of influence. An example of this is in Numbers chapter 32, verse 6 and 7, where God told Moses to send out 12 men to go take a look at the promised land and bring back a report, an update, because God said you can have this amazing place of land, milk, and honey. Moses said unto the children of Gad and to the children of Reuben, shall your brethren go to war and you sit here? Verse number 7 of chapter 32. And wherefore discourage you the heart of the children of Israel from going over to the land which the Lord hath given unto them? Long story short is the spies came back, and only 2 out of the 12 had a positive report. 10 of them said, we saw giants. It looks difficult. There's no way we can have what God says we can have. How many believe when God gives you a word, he's not lying to you? How many believe when God says you can have it, you can have it? Now, you may not get it by Friday, but he said you're going to have it. Only 2 spies came back and says, no, God said we can do this. We are well able to take this. Because the people heard a negative report and they did not go for what God said they could have. Now, listen to this. They never made it to the promised land. The next generation made it. Don't lose out on your promised land by letting somebody speak negative into your life. Don't let somebody else say, well, I tried and it didn't work. Or I heard this and I heard that. I don't know what you heard, but all I heard is what the word of God says, that with God nothing is impossible. Luke 1 and 37, all I heard is speak to the mountain, Mark 11, and it shall be removed and cast into the sea. I don't need to hear your whining or your negativity. I need to hear your faith, because it is no secret what God can do. What he's done for others, God can do for you. Why is the Christian to go forward? Not only living in neutral hurts those around us, but no battles are ever won by going backwards. Think about that. Not one battle is ever won by running from your responsibility. Luke chapter 9, verse 62, Jesus was pretty intense. He said, if you're a disciple, if you're a Christian, Jesus said unto him, no man, no person having put his hand to the plow, became a Christian, started following me, and you look back, you are not fit for the kingdom of God. Jesus said, once you join, you're in. Once you're a child of the King, there's no retreat. Once you put your hand to the plow, I don't want to hear there's a pandemic. I don't want to hear about the price of gas. I don't want to hear about all this going on. I'm the God of all seasons. Come on, say amen. He said, no battles are ever won by going backwards, so put your hand to the plow and keep walking forward by faith. If you can only take little steps, but keep on taking steps of faith, because God in one day can make up for 5 years of loss in your life. It only takes one moment of God's favor to turn everything around. You may have struggled for 3 years, but in 3 days, God is about to give you a resurrection in the name of Jesus. Psalm chapter 78, verse number 9, about that says, the children of Ephraim, being armed and carrying bows and arrows, God had them positioned to win the victory. Look what they did. Turn back in the day of battle. They let the devil intimidate them, and they lost everything that they could have had. I want the devil to hear me say something on this microphone. I don't want to lose any blessings. I don't want to lose any open doors. I don't want to lose any favor. I don't want to lose any increase or acceleration on my life. Friend, I'm going to, listen, if I'm in front of the Red Sea, I'm going to hold up the rod of God, which is the Bible, and I'm going to trust God. Even if I start walking in the water and I get just under my chin and I'm gargling, I know God is going to make a way, because just like when Peter walked on the water, he thought he was going to drown, but Jesus, he may let you sink a little, but he will not let you drown. Oh, I'm thinking of another truth here. Why is a Christian to go forward? Choosing to give up does not win battles or advance your life. Choosing to give up does not win battles or advance your life. Luke chapter 5, verse number 4. Now, when he had left speaking, he said unto Simon, launch out into the deep and let down your nets for a draught or a catch. You know the story of Peter? He had given up. He made money and paid bills and paid people off catching fish. That was his business. He had finally hit the wall, and he said, we have tried. We've been out there all night long. But guess what? He went forward one more time. Jesus said, I don't care how you feel, you haven't slept all night, get the net out. Yeah, but there's fish, it's daytime. You don't fish in the daytime, we do it at night. It's when we get our best response. Jesus said, get the net, get in the boat, and go forward. Peter caught so much fish, he got out of debt, all his bills were paid, he had a reset, and he became a disciple of Christ. All because of two words. He said, I'm going to go forward in the midst of this adversity. Here's something else. God tells us to go forward and take steps of action. Do you know that when we refuse to take steps of action, we are disobeying God? In James chapter 1, verse 22, it says, be doers of the word, not hearers only. Some people will only say amen, and it ends there. They do nothing with the word and the power. But he said, if you'll be a doer of the word, you'll be blessed. But if you are not a doer, you will deceive your own selves. It's going to take more than an amen. It's going to take the amen and the prayer and the action and the phone call and the digging and the reaching and keep on going. And one door closes, go to another door. This doesn't work out, try something else. Because if you'll put action on faith, you will get a reaction from God. Somebody shout amen right now. Here's another truth as I'm getting ready to close this message as your musicians come. Jesus frees us from the things that hold us back. You see, I really have no excuse. not to go forward. Because Jesus, when he died on the cross, he took everything that would ever intimidate me or hold me back, he took that on himself. He said, I have freed you up to be everything I have called you to be. Jesus said in John 8:36, if you know what I did on the cross, if you knew I came back from the dead and I defeated the devil, I set you up for victory. If the Son therefore shall make you free, you shall be free indeed. Can I get somebody to shout, I'm free, I'm free, I'm free? Shout it four or five times. I am free. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. And then one more thing I want to share in this message is this. Forward is the only way to our promised land and the next level of living that God has for us. I want to read this verse, Galatians chapter 6, verse 9. You could call this the formula, the scriptural capsulized formula of getting to that next place, that next level, that next dream. Here it is. And let us not be weary in well-doing. For in due season, God's appointed time, you shall reap. But here it is. If you faint not. I want everybody to shout this after me. Say, in the name of Jesus, I will not go backward, but I will go forward in Jesus' name. I will not be discouraged. I will not give up because I'm on my way to the biggest blessing I've ever had in the name of Jesus. Can we rise to our feet? I want us to have a prayer together. Because I believe that it is a new season coming to you and coming to me. I believe that what the devil has meant for bad, that God is going to turn it around into something good in the mighty name of Jesus. I want all of you to stretch your hands out to me right now. Those of you online, I want you to stretch your hand out. And I want us to repeat this prayer together as a response to the message that I preached called Go Forward. Come on, shout it. Shout it in your living room, wherever you are. Shout it. Say, in the name of Jesus, I will not let the devil push me backward, but I'm going forward in the name of Jesus. No matter the circumstance, no matter the challenge, no matter the pain, I will go forward. I will move forward. In the name of Jesus, I have come too far to turn back now. I know the best is in front of me. In Jesus' mighty name, thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Give the Lord a shout right now. God bless you, and thank you for being for the 9 a.m. hour of power, Faith and Friends Sunday. God bless you. Amen.